Thousands of Virgin Australia passengers have been stranded across the country after check-in systems failed. A global computer fault crashed the airline's reservation program, forcing the cancellation of more than 30 flights and delaying a number of others.
Been told very little, actually, and it's been very annoying and very frustrating.
We were told to come over here and wait, and then we stood in a queue, and then they said, no, you have to go back where you started from again.
It was a bit hopeful. I'd already checked in, so I thought, maybe. But no luck, so they gave me a cookie and that's all that's happened so far. I don't even know where I should be.
Check-in chaos also affected international carriers, including British Airways, American Airlines and Virgin America. A rare natural event, described as by witnesses as a tornado, has ripped through a Perth construction site. 10 workers were injured when the waterspout hit land, triggering a scaffolding collapse just metres from the beach. Two of the injured were rushed to hospital with suspected neck and spinal injuries. The Bureau of Meteorology is now trying to determine what caused the freak weather event. Victoria's only female premier has revealed she is battling throat cancer. Joan Kerner was diagnosed last month after 3 decades of public life. After retiring from politics, the 75-year-old co-founded Emily's List, a support network for Labor women.
Joan Kerner is an inspiration to women across the country, particularly in Victoria. We wish Joan all the best for her fight.
Ms. Kerner has asked for privacy as she undergoes treatment. A man has pleaded guilty to streaking during the State of Origin decider. A more modestly dressed Wattie Homewood fronted a Sydney court today, pleading guilty to 2 charges, including obscene exposure in a public place. No stranger to streaking, Homewood did the same thing 2 years ago during the Warriors-Tigers semi-final. He'll be sentenced later this month. The embattled bombers are stepping up security as D-Day nears on the supplement saga. A fence has been put up around the players' car park. It comes as the club denies asking coach James Heard to stand aside as the ASADA investigation plays out.
Yeah, the club spoke to me last night and said they want me to stay as the coach.
And you're happy to stay?
I want to stay, of course I do.
Former Adelaide captain Mark Rusciuto made the claims yesterday, which he now says he hopes are wrong. The Queensland government is in damage control over a sex scandal involving an MP. Peter Dowling has apologised to family and colleagues after he was caught texting obscene photos of himself to a former mistress. She claims they had sex in his parliamentary office.
I don't want pity. I only ask that my family be left alone while this matter is considered by the clerk.
Mr. Dowling has since quit as the boss of Parliament's Ethics Committee. A high-profile lawyer found not guilty of murdering his wife last year has returned to court. Prosecutors want Lloyd Rainey to face a retrial. Today they described a dinner place card with his name on it, found near his wife's grave, as a smoking gun in the case. After a 3-month trial, Mr. Rainey was acquitted of murdering his wife, Corin, but prosecutors appealed, claiming there were errors of law in the judgment. A quick look at the weather across the country tonight. It's currently 16 degrees in Townsville, 13 at the moment in Brisbane, 15 degrees in Sydney, 11 in Melbourne, 12 degrees in Adelaide and 19 in Perth.